Hello and welcome to another episode of Let's Play on Fulton Farm. And we start today off in the miracle store. Well, shop even. And as you can see from the money, I've just added a little bit to the loan. Got some load of utensils and a new bale trailer for when we have to do round ones. And this trailer accommodates pretty much any kind of pallet or bale you can possibly make in the game, including the ones out of the mod contest with the chrome baler. You can change the bale size. This trailer can do every single size of the baler. This trailer's probably a bit overkill. Tractor's probably a bit overkill for the trailer that I've got on here. Oh, it should be alright. Just got an axle off the ground as well. Some bales to put away. I want to give some root crops to the pigs, and I also want to buy another grass field. And I didn't realise that when we done that other grass, I was saying I don't think we got another grass field. You can actually cut the sheep field. I didn't realise how big our sheep field actually was. I think the Massey's in here to offload these things. As you can see, I've brought all the bales in from the other field. We've got some here. We've got one stack up at the beef and pig. And we got a few stacks in the other yard ready to sell. Probably want that little bit of extra money. Wrong one. Just take that one off. We got a pallet fork. I thought just in case we do any forestry work. And you can change the size of it. I thought if we do some forestry work, then we can at least we can lift the pallets. If we want to replant. And I may end up doing sheep after all. I think it's best just to get every animal going on the map, really. And well, that's not good. And then got a manure fork. I think I'll keep that one right here for when we go in and when we need that. It's not in the way there, should be fine. Alright, I'm gonna have to move that tractor out of the way now. Not too sure where to put the bale trailer right now, I'll probably just stick it in over here somewhere. The Massey tends to live in between all the straw, so this trailer can live over here. I'll put the link in the description for all the new Flegal trailers. They're onto their fourth version now, so they're getting a bit more refined. This one over here. Now that field that's finished being ready. Let's park out there. And the John Deere is currently out on another field cultivating. as you can see on the glance mod. Still in that small square field that we got. Oh, I bought some chickens as well. Close this gate. Gotta give him some wheat, some water. I should have bought the grass field whilst I was out the direction that it's in. I had a look around fields and that's the best one I can think for money. It's a good size, it's right next to the shop as well. Alright. I'm only going to take a bucket's worth of fruit crop up to the pigs. I had to put a back weight on this Massey. I found it was very susceptible to tipping over when you had one or two square bales on it. A full load in the bucket. It tended to like to fall forward. So that's why we got that on there. It comes with the Allo front loader kit that you can get off of Stefan Morris's page. Also the guy that released the rock merger. I'll just turn around here a minute. And I'm gonna tip the rest of that grain out today and we'll get rid of the wood chips. As well take the trailer now. Too many things need doing. And I'll just top up this whilst we're here. So it's going to take a little bit, but oh dear. Misjudge that. I think I'm going to end up having to open that second gate. No point in struggling trying to get through it. Wrong yard. I'm pretty used to going into the cow yard now. Now I finished harvesting. Just gonna tip this one straight in through. And this. As you can see, we've got plenty of bales to sell when we need them. I think once we've bought the other field and that, our priority will be to pay back the loan, really. I think I've got 90,000 out on it. Something like that. Wood chips, we'll do that now. Come by the field also up there. Bit of a mess around episode so far. Sorry about that. I don't know if I'm gonna need the weight on the back for the weight of wood chips. I'm loaded wood chips. I know this isn't gonna get me much money, but every little helps. Yeah, it is quite heavy on the front there. I thought this trailer accepted wood chips. Never mind then, we won't be doing that. That is weird. Pretty sure that trailer accepts wood chips. We won't be doing that today then. Take this trailer back down to this yard. So, I'm hoping you guys are liking the series so far. I've enjoyed making it, that's for certain. Just been a bit lucky that work has been a bit slack this week, so I've had plenty of chance to make loads of episodes. Well, not loads, but this one here will be... Today, episode 4 will go out, but I'm recording this for in a couple days' time. That kind of thing. Just to try and keep ahead, make the most of the days off I've got, so you guys got something to watch. Right. So, what do I do now? Let's see how this one's getting on. It's getting there. I think we shall go up by that field that I was on about and see how much it is to buy another seed drill. Put a tractor on the seed drill in field 13. Let's say seed drill field 11. I plan on getting the Vardenstad, I think that's how you say their name, the 900S. Nice, wide, big model. I think I'll put some barley in. And that will be for whole crop. And our forage harvester problem shouldn't be a problem. Alright, first things first, this is the field. Ooh, that's close. Hop over the gate. 19,000, and it's quite a good size for it. So there we go. We now own field number 6. So it's getting there. I always kind of take more of a pride buying land than I do over anything else. Quite a bit bad once I've got basic machinery. I'd rather struggle on through and buy all the fields. So we have 50,000. Still haven't downloaded Follow Me. Got the rental mod though. So let's have a look here. We got harvesters. See, got all these harvesters here. And now I haven't edited this. This is how it come out with the unzip file. And it's got a few errors in that in the log. Nothing to rent for an hour. And £2 to buy. Now I haven't touched the model whatsoever. Just unzip the folder and put all of that and the headers into my mods folder. That's all I've done. So Bit like when they make a mess up in real life, take advantage of the price because they can't do anything about it. So, and even the headers are cheap. £2 for the carrier. I don't know why it's like this. Whether it is a design error. I do not have a clue what the thinking was behind that. But we'll have that and we'll have that. So there you go. Not too bad. We won't bother getting a grass header. Any grass I do will be bales, or I'll get a wagon. Oh, another thing I was going to check out was 453 pound an hour. So I think we'll rent that for, how much is that? Ooh, that's expensive. Have it for 5 hours, 4 hours, 5 hours. Have it for 5 hours. And there we go. Now we can get on with plenty of seeding. So you can see more of it on screen, because otherwise there would be a lot of seeding going off screen. And I don't want to start doing too much off screen. I did a fair bit off screen in this one. I baled field 11. Auto stacked them all. Tidied up the rest of the other field. Put the John Deere to work. So there was a little bit since the last episode, which I have done, and you guys didn't get to see. I may do a short time-lapse video on selling the straw bales in the yard. I don't think I want to waste an episode on doing that. Assuming we're on rented time with this thing, I think it's best to get on with the time to get on with the seeding. I was going to use the big bag mod on this map, but the problems it creates and everything is just not really worth it. Oh, I hate reversing this thing. Not the best of reversing as it is. There we go. Yeah, so I'm not going to use the big bag mod, because it's just not really worth the time, and things flying off the way it does, and it's just not really worth it. So I'm not going to bother with that. Right. So we got that one there. We got this one here. Barley in that field. Alright, I get close enough. Now, what was the key I'm looking for there? X. first one back up. Right. And away we go. I'm just going to do a quick cheat here, I think, with this. Nah. I'll just set it going, hopefully it will be alright. Right, make sure they're both set to the same. We'll set that one going. It'll probably go the wrong way, I expect. So we may have to sort this one out in a bit. But at least we are getting some seed back in the ground. Better get on with this one, as it is rented. Now if the John Deere's finished, I'll quickly go out and view that field. Oh, a few frame drops on. And there's bits missed. There and everywhere. Right, I'll unfold this. This is a direct seed drill, so I'm not too worried about the bits that are missed. Put this. Do a little bit of cultivating there. It's best to have the land prepped as much as possible. So, this field's nearly done. Are you ready for the reseed? Field 11 will be directly planted. Give the John Deere a bit of a break. It's been doing a lot of cultivating lately. It's a tractor that I use, but you don't see much of it. It's one of them weird ones. There we go. I think this thing needs to go in the garage and have a look at it. It's a little bit dodgy on its revs. So this field ain't that big. This field will be combined. This one won't be. For a whole crop. So I still gotta bring in some form of money whilst I've got things going on. I've been wondering about doing some harvest. Some tree work. rent machinery for some forestry. Wait, it's still quite light on the front end, even with the weight. But yeah, I mean, just do a few trailer loads of wood chips. Just get some money in. Thing is, as I'm normally building maps, and when I do load them in game, I use the money cheat. So I've always got at least 300,000, so I just choose a bit of machinery and buy it. None of this having to graft for it, like I'm having to do in this Let's Play. So it's good for me as well as Let's Play, it means I'm playing the game properly, how it should be played. Well. That'll do. Just keep it in there. Apparently I can't get out now. Well, I could get past that. Yeah, I'm really enjoying playing a map properly, doing it the way the game is meant to be done. There we go, running like Sonic the Hedgehog back towards this tractor. Right, everything's in check here. And we're going to plant some wheat in this one. Oh, I've never done seeding. I've never seen much seeding actually in real life either. Oh dear. So I'm not too sure how you're meant to seed. Whether you go around headlands and then up and down, or around and then headlands afterwards. I don't have a clue. I don't know how it's meant to be done. Should probably watch a video on YouTube on how to do it, so it's a bit more realistic. I ain't too worried about too much realism for now. So this field shouldn't take long to do at all with this one. Should be over quite quickly. Overlapping a bit too much then. But it will be, oh my days. Terrible. Terrible work from here. This tractor actually goes really fast for the size of this drill. I know drilling's done at a fair old speed. This is something else. I'm just going to go up and down the field in random orders like this. Really not the way to do it, I don't think, but it gets the seed into the ground, and that's all that matters. Finish this field now. Just a little bit left. Oh, OK. keep her on the side and go back for that little bit. That's all of this field done. Thought I would skip ahead there. I don't think that you'd want to watch the whole field being done. Before I start this field, just want to go and check on the Massey Ferguson, see how that one's doing. Looking at the cows moving away in there. It's come a fair way so far. It's quite a long field, this one, to do. Down to 61%, so we will have to refill that one, I expect, at some point. Still got a long way to go yet, mind. Go back to field 11. And I'll probably seen some cultivating today. Whether you'd want to see it, I don't know. But I don't know whether you'd want to see all of this field cultivated. Hello, me trying to think of things trying to say. What's cultivating a field of this size? I may do the majority of this field off with camera. And if I get a spare quiet moment this weekend, I will do some live streaming of Willow Tree Farm. I think it was Craig come up with the idea to stream a different map so people didn't miss out too much on this map, and that way you also get to see my new map that I'm making. So yeah, hopefully I'll get around to doing some of that. It'd be good to do some streaming. I haven't done any streaming. It'll probably be through YouTube, not Twitch. Get in this corner. See, what would be nice is to have a challenger doing this. It's one thing I'm looking forward to in FS17, being able to use challengers. That will be good, that will. As long as I'm not working when that game comes out, I plan on doing a good few hours streaming on the night of release. Should have it quiet then, so it won't be on during the day, I don't think. But that night I will be streaming it live. First impressions, basically, and what I think of it. But then we've got to October till that happens, so no worry just yet for that. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode.